always tell the kids, what does this look like? Squint your eyes, even adults. And they'll usually say, oh, it looks like the heart, and these big veins called the Potomac River and the Rappahannock River are these major arteries coming to the heart, but you can see that they're full of sediment after a rainstorm. And we all know when your veins get clogged, things are heading in the wrong direction. And so when a little stream, vein, or artery is impacted, it's going to impact the whole system. So we're going in one capillary vein at a time and trying to put the system back in place. This is called Cattail Creek, or the Berrywood Stream Restoration Project. The community really brought this project to the state and said, we have a big problem with our stream. It's incised, it's degraded. It isn't what we remember 10, 20 years ago.
In 79, this was the go-to place for yellow perch fishing.
Our job was to come in here and put together a bay restoration project using funds from the Atlantic and Coastal Bay Trust Funds. The basis of our funding is nitrogen and phosphorus reduction. This stream is a conduit with fine sediments, clays, and sands that erode out of the system from stormwater that carries nitrogen and phosphorus to the bay. So we wanted to stop that.
Cattail Creek is one of the largest watersheds in all of the Magathie. Many of the areas that it meanders goes through an area of high development, which translates to a lot of impervious land.
In the bay, the nitrogen phosphorus goes down and causes massive algae blooms. And when that algae only lives for like 24 hours, maybe a little bit longer, it dies en masse, the oxygen levels drop. The difference in what this looks like now and what it looked like before is somewhat undescribable. But it was incised, maybe 3 to 4 feet, I'd say. It was soft deposition of fine sediments from way up in the watershed along the Route 2 corridor. This particular design was to put in cobble riffle weirs. Yeah, it doesn't quite look like normal coastal plain, but to handle what's coming off of Route 2, which is literally a half mile from here, you can't use wood and a cute little design. You've got to really get in there and engineer your project. The plants are going to do the rest of the work.
In the middle of it all, it can be a little alarming if you didn't kind of grow up in it all. It's stream wetland complexes. You got a million moving pieces, so you're kind of trying to like herd these million pieces forward, and that's our goal, and that's what we do.
We had a very large storm yesterday. Back in the old days, before the restoration, the stream would be looking very muddy and murky with a lot of sediment. Today, it's running clear.
The plants are like, oh, thanks for the structure. We're coming in. We're going to slow this water down, spread it out, sink it in.
We've seen the return of so many species of muskrat and beaver and fox, lots of birds. We've had Baltimore orioles here, which are actually quite rare.
Wow.
So if nothing else, the diversity of, look at how many different plants you've got. You know, this is exactly what you're looking for.
The grade controls that we created with the trust fund money has pushed the water up and out and reconnected this system. Now, that duck and that baby duck just came right underneath this pretty busy road. This was the biggest challenge, but it's really important to the stream restoration project. So starting right here was a bulkhead. We were like, all right, we've come this far. We got to finish this off. What would you think if we just pulled out your bulkhead and put in a living shoreline? You know, half the neighborhood loved it, the other half didn't even really know what we were saying. We came out here constantly after the project, and we measured and we measured and we measured. We never saw one sand, one gravel, one cobble move 1 inch. And it was really the nature of the material we use. The big slug of tide comes up and goes down. This is a big part of the ecosystem. But once those plants establish, this thing is good to go for hundreds, if not thousands of years. You saw it up the middle and the end, and then you can see it's a great approach, and we're talking rockfish, and all the young year fish can come up here and have cool, protective water from their predators. This project is extremely successful, and I have to say that one whole half of that is the community and how they've stuck with this project.
Technically, one of the biggest things that we had done was to reconnect the stream with the floodplain, but perhaps what was even more significant was that we reconnected the community with their stream.